Hello everybody, my name is Zohri Chaudhary and today we'll talk about ionizing and non-ionizing radiation. Radiation, so the term radiation refers to energy traveling through space, and there are two types of radiation, ionizing and non-ionizing. Ionizing radiation has enough energy to remove tightly bound electrons from atoms, thus creating ions. Its properties are used to generate electric power, to heal cancer cells, in many manufacturing processes. Some examples are alpha radiation, beta radiation, gamma radiation, as well as X-rays. The alpha radiation releases alpha particles, and the beta radiation releases beta particles. Non-ionizing radiation, on the other hand, has just enough energy to move atoms in the molecules around or cause them to vibrate, but does not have enough energy to remove the electrons. So for the ionizing case, you're actually has enough energy to remove the electrons, whereas for non-ionizing, it doesn't have enough energy to remove the electrons. Example-wise, extremely low-frequency radiation in power lines is an example. AM or FM radio station, VHF TV radio waves also are examples, as well as microwave radiation inside the microwave, infrared radiation, and visible light and ultraviolet all are examples of non-ionizing radiation. In this chart, we can see the various ionizing and non-ionizing radiation in the electromagnetic spectrum. This is known as the electromagnetic spectrum, and it shows the frequency of the various radiation and the wavelength of those radiation, and they are categorized based on frequency and wavelength. So on the right side in here, where we have high frequency and very small wavelength, we can see ionizing radiation in here, and we can see X-rays and gamma rays on this end of the spectrum. And why they are the ionizing, as we mentioned earlier, they can create ions, they can break bonds, as a result cause DNA damage and lead to cancer mutation and birth defects. On the left side of this electromagnetic spectrum, right here, if we draw a line in here, this is where we are dividing the ionizing from the non-ionizing. On the left side of the spectrum, we have the non-ionizing radiation, and we can look at them in three different parts. Non-ionizing radiation that are optical in nature, non-ionizing radiation that are thermal in nature, and non-ionizing radiation that are non-thermal or produces low induced currents. So the one that are on this side, they are known as the ELF or extremely low frequency radiation, and this is what we see in power line and static fields. So very small frequency and very large wavelength. On the center in here, we can see radiation that are thermal in nature that releases heat. Examples are radio frequency in the AM, FM radio antenna, as well as TV waves, the TV signal that travels through air, and also the signal in mobile phones and microwaves. They're all example of non-ionizing radiation that produces thermal heat. And right here, in between, towards the right side of this spectrum, very close to the non-ionizing radiation, very close to the ionizing radiation, we have the infrared radiation, or IR, and these are the optical kind. They produce electronic excitation and releases light as a result. So examples are infrared light, heat lamps, as well as visible light, the light that help us to see from the sun, and ultraviolet light as well. And ultraviolet is right at the cusp between ionizing and non-ionizing radiation. So some of the ultraviolet rays does produce a little bit of the property of ionizing radiation, especially that UVC kind located right in here. Okay. Again, this is the same electromagnetic spectrum, and it just shows the wavelength in here and some of the more popular item or things that you may be familiar with, and the diameter of each of these places or the length of each of these things corresponds to the wavelength that you're seeing in here to give you an idea how those wavelengths are. So for example, radio waves in here are each wavelength is at the size of like a building. Microwave on the other hand is much smaller, and then as you go to gamma rays, they are the size of atomic nuclei. Okay, so let's do some quick concept check. Alpha, beta, gamma radiation are examples of which type of radiation? Ionizing radiation, A, very good. Which of the following is an example of non-ionizing radiation? They are all examples of non-ionizing radiation, D. Thank you.